Let's get to Mitchell Fitzgerald. So far, you don't have enough time with him. He's not great in flying force. So around the turn, you can try to straight up the highest point of the earth. He goes 800 foot above sea level. You probably won't be able to see down because of the fog, but we'll check it out right here. That's a camera, I suppose, is worth it. Okay, we're pitching 2 miles. No, we won't be there in 2 minutes. We're like 15 miles an hour or better. So if you're good at math, I'm like myself, you can figure out. It's easy to figure out. You go 60 miles an hour. It takes you 1 minute to go 1 mile. So it's only 50 miles an hour. That's 1.5% 60, so you only need to take 4. So it takes 4 minutes to drive 1 mile up here. So I'm going 23 miles an hour, which should be better in 6 minutes. Let's see how long the video is. See if it reaches 6 minute mark. The god is 23 miles north forward, so this is about 3 miles shy. The gate of Perpetua is about 3 miles just out of the gods. The light comes is 20 miles from my house. Imagine what this looked like 300 years ago. It's just, you know, the Native American Indians in here. There were thousands and thousands of whales everywhere. Probably half a million sea lions. And when the Indians walked on the beach, I heard a story. I got a friend of an Indian here now. He's a local Native American Indian. The Saishwa tribe, that's how he calls himself. It's the Saishwa Indians. He said, you know, seriously, 300 years ago, he walked on the beach, the Indians just lying on the beach. There's so many Indians, they didn't want to pick him up. Why would they? Back then, Indians like travel today. But because so many people have been talking for the last 8 years, we can be harder to find. But back then, 200 years ago, whatever, you walk on the beach here, and it's just nothing. I just show you that as an example. How amazing, I mean, imagine how big all the trees were 200 years ago on the coast. And don't get me wrong, I'm all about cutting down trees to use them outside your house. But today, you can actually cut down trees to make houses out of plastic if you want to. Take all the old plastic out of the little, you know, dump, you're going to go far. And compress it all, and make like these houses you can just snap together like nails. Because the plastic, the walls are so thick, they really don't need insulation. Yeah, see, we're almost on top of 6 minutes now, so maybe 30 seconds to get to the front of it. Oh, look how beautiful it is. I already watched the video yet. I always smart out though, video the up here. I first one up here. It's exactly 8:30 in the morning. Oh, look at that. I can't believe. Sometimes it blows my mind. There's 8 billion people on here. And I will not be. I'm nobody from nowhere. I'm the only person at the top of Cape Perpetua. See, that's how God's blessed me. There's 8 billion people on here. And I'm the only one at the top of Cape Perpetua. How many people can say they experience these things in life?
Look at how foggy it is here. That's the bottom of Cape Perpetua. I can't see through the fog. I can barely see the trees over there. It's so foggy here right now.